Hello everyone and welcome to another Thomas videos. So today we're going to be taking a look at Re:Scavenator in Thomas format. So recently there was a Thomas tournament and Re:Scavenator happened to have won that tournament. And this list comes from the username Tyrant. So I'm going to be taking a look at a Re:Scavenator today. But before we get into it, I did undergo a very small change with the deck. I have added a copy of a Demonic Tutor so that we can Demonic Tutor into a Reanimate or Unearth given the situation. And I have also added a copy of a Val'Gavoth, a Terror Eater, as a little added spice to the deck. But honestly, the real meat here is the fact that this deck is housing a new card called Abhorrent Oculus. I've done a few videos now with this little eyeball, and time again, this card is just surprising me so much. So compared to usual Reanimators, this deck on the other hand has a lot of small creatures. A lot of our creatures come from our 2-drops and 3-drops. What's cool about the Oculus in this deck is the fact that not only can you manifest into something like another Oculus, but let's say if you see an Atroxa, or you see a Val'Gavoth after looking at the top two cards, the card that you don't select with the Oculus actually goes to the graveyard, which means that following turn, you could also reanimate that card onto the battlefield. And at the same time, if you see a Psychic Frog and you see that you have Val'Gavoth or Atroxa stuck in your hand, you could also manifest into a Psychic Frog into discarding these cards. So there's a lot of lines that you can take with the Oculus, which makes it pretty prevalent to the point where I kind of want to go up to even the fourth copy of this in the deck. Another cool neat trick here is with Psychic Frog and the Diviner of Fates. If you have Psychic Frogs and Diviner of Fates on the same board, the Psychic Frog can discard a card at any time, which means Diviner of Fates, which triggers only once per turn, you can also take advantage of the Diviner of Fates, seeking a card whenever you discard a card. You can do that on opponent's turn as well. So a lot of cool stuff going on here. So having said that, I'm going to be hopping over to some Thomas Best of 3 to show you guys how the deck does. So let's hop on over. Well. We do have a reanimate. But with nothing else. Let's see how that goes. Dark Ritual. Soren. Looks like a go next situation. Alenda. Markov grows stronger. Funny enough, if we surveil into Val'Gavoth, we might be able to win here. Let's see. Can we see a miracle? Boom. That's not a miracle. Can we see a miracle here? Boom. Okay. Next game, please. We want swords. I'm not sure about the surgical in this matchup, but I guess I'll try something like this. I guess Bowmaster is pretty much useless. And I think the Oculus might be a tad too slow. We'll see. Nope. I think I'll keep this one. Four cards. Okay. Opponent keeps it on top. Pretty bad surveils today. My opponent also seems like they have a surgical. Reef. Let's deny the surgical there. Oh, that is a wonderful card. Did they top again? Wait, did they actually top again? Because that would be insane if they topped it again. Wow. Kind of impressive. Kind of impressive. Okay, very nice. I mean, this is clearly something that they can't play. It's not a land. Hmm. I guess we can get back a Satoru. Very nice. Game saved because of this card. Actually, I'm not gonna lie, this matchup is pretty miserable. Tap lands, but I have to keep it. Might lose the game here. If they have reanimate, we lose the game. Oh my god. This matchup is something else, let me tell you. Okay, it's an ephemerate. We're good. We're good. Really? Interesting. Another reanimate. What do I do with this? I guess they could have, like, something I can reanimate. Wait, why did they not take the reanimate then? Wait, that doesn't make sense. Wait, my opponent just threw the game. What? Okay. I should probably take that. Get a Diviner of Fate. And then we can discard that. Just so funny. Oh my god, please. Opponent. How did they do that? This game is nonsensical. Yeah, it really is. So that's a land on top. Okay. They're dead. What was this game? The most all-in game ever, right? Goblin Bombardment. Now I regret not using the grief. Can we reanimate once? I would like to see Bal'Gavoth or Atroxa reanimate this game if we can. Juggernaut. Yeah, this deck seems like it's very much of a struggle versus these kind of decks. It's very hard. Yep, the game's over. So let's have some swords in. Stone of Eric in. Deluge in. I think that's about it. Cut the griefs. Cut the ephemerates. And try that. Always have this problem, right? This deck, it's hard to get the piece that can discard a card and a piece that reanimates a card. It's very difficult. Okay, that's definitely sticking. The opponent currently has a surgical in hand. I knew this was gonna happen. Maybe I should just crack this now and then try to unearth. So, like, I need them to, like, waste their surgical, you know? I mean, they're not going to use a surgical on that, honestly. There's three cards in the yard. Let's see. Do I give them energy? Or should I just swords? I feel like I should just swords. Because I'm trying to like fill up the graveyard for the Oculus, so maybe like this isn't so bad. Lightning bolt. Surprised they play that. Five cards in the yard. I think I might just cycle this now. Okay. Another Amphiraptor. That's not good. Into a Bowmaster. Two, three, four, five, six. I go to eight. I think we just deluge. Why aren't they activating the Goblin Bombardment? Do they perhaps think that Stunomeric shuts it down? Maybe. I mean, that could be it. Oh, do they have a swords? Nope. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. What does the bombardment say? Yeah, it says sacrifice a creature. It doesn't say that it deals damage if it dies. I mean, I'm not sure if it actually would have mattered too much. I would have still been at 8. Oh my god. Can I reanimate? Can I reanimate? Another Bowmaster. I think one is fine. Soul Guide Lantern. Let's kill the also the pride. They don't have a land. Wow. I got lucky. Yeah, I definitely got lucky there. One day. One day I'll get Vagvoth or Aatrox out. It's just so hard. I don't know. It is so darn hard. What am I supposed to do with this hand? I'm just so greedy. Like, there's just no way I can keep that. Oh my god! That's a... Oh my god! If I kept this one, I could have just reanimated with Psychic Frog. My god. Another... Why is this literally every deck I face? Just... energy. Like, what's going on here? Okay. Okay, 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 okay. Attack. Wow. Okay, I'm pretty happy about that actually. So they don't have a removal spell in hand, is what I'm getting. Very nice. So the frog at the moment can grow to 6 toughness. Because of Diviner Fate. Another Oslo of Pride. Let me just do this now. Unearth. Okay. Let us get rid of the Ocelot of Pride. That card is way too dangerous. And I'll exalt 3 cards. Probably attack with this to draw a card. Grief. Do I grief my opponent? I think I actually will. Okay, never mind. That was actually a terrible idea. That was a terrible idea. I take 4 damage. Oh my god. How many Ocelot prize do you have? What? That's insane. Might actually lose this one. We just can't find the... Yeah, we actually might lose this one, unfortunately. I feel like everything just came out a little bit too late. If I bend the Orcish Bowmaster, I can draw 2 creatures. I don't think I can actually bend the Orcish Bowmaster, honestly. Yeah, what a tough game. What a tough game. Yeah, I actually think we can't win. I don't think so. I don't think there's a single card that can save me because they have a Goblin Bombardment which can block our life gain. And they're just going to play Loras here with another Ocelot Pride. I don't think there's a single card that can actually win us the game, even if an Aatrox comes down here. So let's just go to next game. Wow, that's crazy we actually lost that one. 2 Ocelot Prides coming down with the 2 Guide Up Souls. Actually, 3 Ocelot Prides. Wow. That really got us. Yeah, that was just way too many. Way too many. Okay. Should be a lot better with the swords though. Yeah, the problem with the reanimate targets, if these don't come down on turn 2 or 3, these can't ever come down. That's really the problem with this card, with these cards and reanimate. You just lose too much life, and then once you do, you just die to a Goblin Bombardment. Should I actually have Lavinia in this matchup? I mean, maybe. Yeah, we'll keep this one. It's not the prettiest hand. But we got a Psychic Frog plus a Diviner of Fates, which seems pretty strong to me. Okay. I can technically avoid this, but it's pretty much a gamble at that point. That I feel like I should just let this go. We need a black source. Okay. Juggernaut. So they're gonna take my reanimate. It's kind of annoying. Oh wow. I think that actually might win the game. Okay, that's game. That's actually game. Double Oculus. Okay, maybe never cut the Oculus. I've been playing this game wrong the whole time?
Nothing can break our bond.
Yeah, I've been playing this game wrong the whole time? Yeah, this is just insane. Okay, never mind. Oculus, insane. Absolutely insane. This was actually not a Valgavoss showcase. This video was about an abhorrent Oculus showcase. Is it not? Okay, let's cut a Valgavoss. Okay, boop, boop, boop. Monkey. I really wanted to go Stone of Eric first, but kind of hope they had. Okay, they went for Juggernaut. They gotta get rid of the frog. Too good. We are just too good. That was a classic Thoughtseize bug.
Nothing is more important than family.
Okay. This turn is insane. Wow. We don't attack, right? I mean, they're gonna be so upset. Oh my god. That's... Oh my god. What was that? Oh man. Okay. I'm almost at a point where I feel like you might want to go up to 4 copies of I. The car is just absolutely busted. Oh my god. How do I take less damage? Something like this? Swords. Okay, that's kind of annoying. That's also kind of annoying. Because I really need that, the Diviner of Fate. How is my opponent doing that? Grief? Another one? I guess I'm just playing Juggernaut after. They're gonna have to take away my abhorrent Oculus here, so. so many energies today. Nice. Nice, and we got an ephemerate. Wow. That's insane. We got a solitude, we got an ephemerate. They already used one swords. Opponent tops it though. This deck plays only two juggernauts in the main deck, I believe. Guide of Souls. Into an Ocelot Pride. I might sacrifice Diviner. A Static Prison. The Ephemerate. Demonic Tutor. There's even a Vel'Koth. It might be too late though. Just grab an Orcish Bowmaster. And let's get rid of Did I get rid of an Ocelot Pride? Yeah, let's get rid of an Ocelot Pride. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Okay, still no Beric. Deluge? Do I want this? I wonder. So many cards we're bringing in though. Yeah, minus one Vel'Koth. Let's just play only one copy of Lauren. We'll go with this. Nice hand. I probably want to just kill it. Okay. Surprise, actually. Why'd they just leave like that? I mean, our hand was absolutely nasty, like Stone of Eric. So they can't play Goblin Bombardment, Psychic Frog, so they have to have a sword to kill it. We have a reanimate. If they kill it, we can get it back. We also have a board wipe. Okay, can we get Vel'Koth out once, please? Oh god. They don't end. How come there's infinite source of energy tonight? Oh my god. Not like this. Maybe they won't have infinite removal spells like every... Wow, they bottomed the... What? How does that even happen?
Fight beside me, brother.
So, what is this exactly? I still block, right? Because I can still kill the Johnny.
I will not rest until I find my brother. We need all the strength we can muster.
Bowmaster? Let's see what I get with this. I can get the Solitude out with the reanimate. That's like the best thing I can do, probably.
I have failed.
Another land. Oh, we're still in this. Never mind. Oh, you know what? I could have also done this. Save the Unearth. Put the Bowmaster. Instead of playing the Shadowy Backstreet, instead of surveilling, I could have unearthed the Orcish Bowmaster. Then I actually would have lived here. Okay. Good to know. There's just endless energies at the moment. I don't know why. Like, there's no other decks at the moment, which is pretty bad for us, honestly, because it's our worst matchup, which is the energy. If I can just reanimate Vagavath just once, I'd be really happy. Even if we lose, like, win or lose, I'd be really happy. I would be really, really happy. They always have that combo. Always seem to have that combo. Okay. I feel like if I'm gonna be playing swords now, I should do it now. Get the Satoru in. Okay. Peddler. You know what I should have done? If I put the Diviner face into the graveyard, I guess they would have just taken the Unearth. So maybe that actually wouldn't have worked. Try that again. Okay. It's a decent hand. If he had a 1-mana card, it would have been fantastic. Wait, my opponent took out the Loris. You see that? Well, I have a plan then. Sure. They must have a Blood Moon, right? Let's just take less damage. I don't want to be taking a lot of damage. Mm-hmm. Why are they playing that? Hey, check this out. Diviner of Fate. Get rid of a Juggernaut. And we're gonna get a Stone of Eric. Boom. Stone? No. Okay, looks like we have to fire this off. Do we actually? It gets rid of these two, but the marionette stays alive. Or I can go Psychic Frog into Orcish Bowmaster. Okay, they're just done. I don't know what is going on today. We just played against so many energy, which is supposedly our worst matchup. Okay, so played a bit of this deck today. This comes from a user named called Tyrant. This is their Esper Rescaminator deck. And it was actually, it was pretty good. I will say I think the change that I made, taking out the Unlicensed Hearse for the Stone of Eric, actually helped in so many cases. Luckily, we actually drew into this Stone of Eric versus those energy matchups. So that was actually incredible. And I've been actually cutting the Oculus at the very start versus energy. But this card is actually straight up broken versus energy, just because the removal spells just don't cleanly answer this unless they have a Swords. And a lot of the times, like, we've actually gone Oculus back to back into Oculus, manifest into an Oculus a bunch of times, which was absolutely game breaking. Like, despite us not getting these out, we were still able to close out the game just by playing these 2-mana or 3-mana creatures. The grief has been pretty bad, I would say. It was not a good card at all. But that's also because we haven't played against a combo deck except for the very first time versus a Soaring combo deck. And in that match, the grief didn't show up, so that didn't really matter. But also, the Solitudes are kind of hard to evoke in this deck because you only have Divinator Fates and Ephemerates. And if you play the multiple copies of Atroxa, so that's probably a good reason to play Atroxa, more copies of Atroxa instead of Valgamoth. But I just wanted to play with Valgamoth today, so. And I feel like diversifying the threats is not bad either because of Surgical. So maybe I would do something like this, like one Valgamoth and two copies of Atroxa. But as you can see, like, Solitude that doesn't have that many hits, even with like three Atroxas. A lot of the times you're not gonna be casting this Solitude unless like you're in a pinch. And the problem with this card is that even if you draw into these white spells, what ends up happening is if you Solitude, pitch an Ephemerate, because this was the only white card in your hand, you don't have an Ephemerate to bounce this back. Those kind of scenarios kind of popped up often, which made it a little bit more awkward. So, like, despite this deck having Ephemerate and Solitude, this doesn't actually happen a lot from my experience. Instead, I can definitely see, like, griefing with Ephemerate probably happens more often because our deck is mostly black. So yeah, I mean, the deck was pretty good. The Abhorrent Oculus, I think, really pushed this deck further. And compared to the old Reanimate deck, where we only had 4 copies of Reanimate, now we can play Unearth, which acts as our 5th and 6th copy of Reanimate. And despite this being a Reanimate deck, you don't really rely too heavily on Atroxas or like Valgamoth to win, which I find a little bit better than the usual Reanimate deck, which gets kind of crushed by a single Surgical. So yeah, I thought the deck was great. The sideboard choices, I didn't even know that Glistening Deluge was a thing too, compared to Toxic Deluge. It makes sense why the author of the deck is playing this card over the Toxic Deluge, just because Toxic Deluge loses you a lot of life. Usually the decks where you want to bring Toxic Deluge would be versus energy matchup anyway. So this is kind of like Toxic Deluge, but you don't actually lose any life. Versus Show and Tell, we haven't even played against a single Show and Tell today. Like, today was just all energy day. I don't know why. Looks like their sideboard choice for the Show and Tell matchup is Lavinia, Boromir, Lauren, and two Surgicals. And because you can also scam your opponent with the Grief Reanimate Ephemerate, you don't technically need the flute as much as some other decks do. So yeah, that is gonna be it for today's video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys all in the next one. Bye bye.